So Mr. Prakash Javadekar is looking to create a mechanism to certify online streaming content. However, this could be a bit problematic, a bit unnecessary, and also a bit tricky. I have with me Nikhil Pava, founder and editor of Medianama, to explain why this could be an essential problem going forward. So Nikhil, what are the ground that exactly Mr. Javadekar is looking for such a move, and what could the possible problems be by such a move?
Well, firstly, Swamy, Mr. Javadekar has gone out in public and said that they're doing this because the court asked them to do it, right? But I looked at the High Court judgment, and the judgment essentially says that they've asked the government, which is the respondent in the case, to seriously consider setting up a content code. It is not a direction from the government. So there's a big difference.
Yeah.
If it's asking the government to seriously consider, it means that they have a choice.
Yes.
And they're choosing to do this. That's point number one. Point number two is that the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting by itself, does it have jurisdiction over the internet? Because is the internet broadcast? Is the internet public viewing? You know, like in cinema, it's public viewing. In broadcast, it's going out to multiple households. And effectively, anyone can quickly tune in and watch it. Most of these subscription services are paid services, they are private services, they're being viewed in people's homes. And so does the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, which is looking at broadcasting by itself, does it have the right to create a code for online content?
Sure.
But that is not to say that a code hasn't already been created. So about a couple of months ago, and in fact this entire process started sometime last year when Smriti Irani, when she was Minister of Information and Broadcasting, set up a committee to regulate news aggregators, content and content aggregators.
Okay.
Now that committee was disbanded eventually because there was significant criticism of it.
Okay.
And there was again the confusion there that does this belong to the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting or does this belong to the Ministry of IT?
Yeah.
And so it was given to the Ministry of IT. Now in those circumstances, why is Mr. Javadekar, MeitY is supposed to look at it, why is Mr. Javadekar creating or looking to create a content code when they have no jurisdiction?
Sure.
Right. The other thing that happened was that after that, and because content creators, especially after Sacred Games and how controversial it became, and because there were cases filed about Sacred Games, they started looking at creating a content code in order to tell courts that, listen, we are responsible people, we are doing something, right? It's not that we're just streaming whatever. So they created an online content code, and a couple of things that were in that code were that there will be no disrespecting of the national flag.
Okay.
Right? There will be representation of children in a suggestive or sexual manner will not happen.
Sure.
Right? Content which deliberately intends to outrage religious sentiments of any class will not be put in. Now that's a tricky one because what's a documentary?
Exactly.
Right? And today in this country, anyone will be offended by anything.
Completely.
So, you know, this is something like a blasphemy code which need not exist because blasphemy itself is, I would say, it shouldn't be illegal. You know, in the same way that I believe that sedition shouldn't be illegal.
Yeah.
But again, sedition is another part of it.
Yeah.
It also says that any content which deliberately promotes or encourages terrorism and violence against the state.
Yeah.
Now, if you go back, there's a show on Netflix called Fauda.
Okay.
And there was a movie called Haider, which depicted a little more realistically the concerns that, for example, Fauda depicted the Palestine-Israel issue in a slightly more balanced way.
Okay.
In the same way that Haider also highlighted the Indian Army's excesses in Kashmir, in Jammu and Kashmir. So would that then be encouraging terrorism in a sense? We don't know. So these are all subjective things.
Sure.
There was also about, you know, so content which is banned by the government for exhibiting online would be banned.
Okay.
Now the thing is that not everyone signed up for this.
Okay.
It's only a few, I think 8 or 9 providers signed up.
Okay.
And it's up to them whether they want to sign up.
Okay.
But what this does is that it gives the hecklers the veto.
Yeah.
Tomorrow anyone will go and start crying to the government that, you know, my religious sentiments have been hurt by something or the other.
Yes.
Then it might get banned or blocked and these guys will block it.
Sure.
It also prevents people from exploring new territory, right?
Yes.
So for example, something that AIB did with its roast was like people hated it, but some people said we don't care.
Completely,
you know, go back to the 90s and you were probably very young then. There was a song that became very controversial called Sexy 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 Mujhe Log Bolein.
Okay.
And there were mobs out complaining against the usage of the word sexy.
Okay.
Is that, I mean, you see that happening now? No. because society evolves.
Yeah, exactly.
So we don't want a nanny code in a sense,
sure,
right? And
sure.
That's what these guys were creating.
Okay.
It also lends itself to the risk that is of what is happening now. So in the court judgment,
yeah,
the court judgment said, yes, we agree that there is a content code that's been created.
Okay.
But they also said that, listen, we don't, it is not enforceable by the government, so the government should consider creating a code.
Right.
So basically, you've given the government something to play with already.
Yes.
Now, we don't know how the government will deal with it, right? In the sense, will they accept it as it is?
Yeah.
Or will they make it a little less stringent?
Yeah.
Or will they make it more stringent?
Yeah.
Now, my guess is, and I don't necessarily trust governments, is that they'll make it more stringent.
Possibly.
They will make it more, so to speak, sanskari.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And so how does that impact freedom to criticize the religions or freedom to criticize your own country?
Yeah.
Because criticism and advocacy is not illegal in this
yeah.
year single judgment.
Yeah.
It wasn't illegal.
Yeah.
So we need to be very cautious
yeah.
about how we proceed from here, because these codes could effectively become censorship codes. And this
sure.
is what you have on TV, which is what you have in cinema.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you can't use the word breast in a movie.
Okay.
And even in subtitles.
Okay.
So, you know, there are and there's a hilarious list of subtitle changes that is public before which it is given a particular certificate.
Yeah.
Right. And if you look at it, most of the providers, the responsible ones, have a parental sort of restriction in the code. So these are they have a separate sign in for children.
Sure.
YouTube is now rolling out YouTube Kids.
Yes.
So that's the other thing. We don't know whether how this will impact online content aggregators, you know,
yeah.
like a YouTube or a
yes.
Vimeo or a Dailymotion.
Yes.
And above all, I think that core question that I mentioned, is it public viewing or private viewing?
Yes.
So if you go back into history, mm-hmm. about a couple of years ago, there was a case in the Supreme Court filed by someone called Kamlesh Vaswani about banning porn.
Okay, yeah.
And the government, and there was a massive outrage saying
yeah.
that how it's, porn is not illegal in India.
Yeah.
I think selling it is, I'm not sure, I'm not a lawyer. But
okay.
The government said, we don't want to do moral policing, we don't want to get into people's bedrooms and see what they're doing there.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So in that context, how will this play out? Because you know, the same regulations or the same content code which is explicitly applies to a Netflix could also apply to porn sites.
Yeah.
So therefore, does the government really have the jurisdiction to go and create these restrictions?
Yeah.
Are they now doing moral policing in this context?
Yeah.
We don't know.
Okay.
My point is that Mr. Javadekar should basically let this go.
Okay.
He doesn't have the jurisdiction for it.
Yeah.
The government doesn't have the right to restrict private viewing.
Yeah.
But at the core of this question,
yeah.
because there's also a case in the Supreme Court
yes.
Regarding regulating these players
yeah.
By a group called Justice for Rights.
Okay.
At the core of this question is,
mm-hmm.
is what you watch on your mobile phone and what you watch on your devices,
mm-hmm.
is that public viewing or private viewing?
Sure.
And therefore, is there grounds to regulate that, because there might be disorder or there might be
yeah.
public order issues, there might be riots, etc.
Yes, yes.
Because, you know, the right to offend is an integral part of fundamental rights.
Yep.
It's a right, it's a part of free speech.
Yes.
As long as it is not, as long as you're not making a call for killing someone, advocacy is fine, criticism
yeah.
is fine.
Yeah.
And I think we have to grow as a society and not become restricted as a society.
Yes, yes.
What the government is probably worried about
mm-hmm.
is that the internet is now penetrating to smaller towns where there are millions of people.
Yes.
And we might have a problem there.
Yeah.
That they may not be exposed to the kind of cultural shifts that we are exposed to in the cities.
Yes.
But I think it's important for us, for the government, not to be patronizing. You know, this is, it shouldn't be a nanny state.
Yes.
At this point in time, that's what it's trying to be.
Okay. Also, Nikhil, as far as I understand, a Netflix and a Hotstar are definitely different from a TikTok, where you find loads of user-generated content.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So in that case, Netflix and Hotstar and other platforms like that aren't necessarily intermediaries
yeah.
and can't be regulated possibly under this, under Section 79 of the IT Act.
Yeah.
So how is that entire thing going to play out?
Well, that's a tricky part, right? Because users aren't uploading content on Netflix and, let's say, Amazon Prime
yes.
or Hotstar.
Yes.
They are.
Yes.
And so therefore, they're not intermediaries, and therefore Section 79 isn't able to ask them, government can't ask them to take down content
yes.
under Section 79, or court order can't ask them to
yes.
do it. But there is still Section 69, which are basically blocking orders.
Okay.
And those can be issued for blocking specific content on the internet.
Okay.
Okay. And so we'll see. I don't think this will necessarily apply to user generated content, because
okay.
it's impossible to control.
Okay.
But there's another mechanism, an amendment to the IT Act, IT rules, which is looking to essentially reduce which is intending to institute proactive takedowns of content.